this is a shutoff valve and it's using a butterfly valve. As you can see, this is a butterfly valve. This is a pneumatic shutoff valve which operates with the pneumatic air, and the pressure is mostly up to 6 bar. This is SOV which change the direction of air, and the pneumatic cylinder operates the butterfly valve. As you can see, 3 ports, 2 are for the drains, this is for drain, and the center port is for the input of pneumatic pressure. This is the section of its limits, so it will show whether it is open or it is closed. It is coupled with this pneumatic cylinder with this shaft. So when we will apply the air with this push-in connector and the SOV will operate, then this pneumatic cylinder will change the direction of this butterfly valve from closed to open. This is a manual push of the solenoid valve. When I will press this push, this butterfly valve will open. So when I press this push button, the path of the air from the SOV changes and the cylinder moves open and close. This is the coil, and here I am using a jack to give it 220 volt. When I will apply the voltage, this butterfly will open, and when there is no power, this will become close. Now I will show you what is inside this limit switch block and how these limits are operated. Here you can see it's written open and close. So from outside we can check whether the position of the butterfly is open or close. Here are two cams which operates the limit switches. In one direction, this green cam will operate the limit switch, and in the other direction, this red cam will operate the second limit switch. Here are the cables connections, so we can use these switches to show the limits open or close on the PLC. Here you can see when this position of the butterfly changes, limits cam changes and it operates the limit switch. Now green is operated and now red, now green. So with the change in position, this limit switch work. I will show you with the multimeter how we can check the limit switches. Here you can see it's zero resistance, that mean limit switch contact is closed and the red cam has operated the limit switch. That's mean the valve is in closed position. When I will operate this valve, here you can see the limit becomes open and now the green limit is operated, but the red is released. So the contact of the limit switch is changed as the position of the butterfly valve changes. Now I will check the second limit switch. As you can see, it's in the contact is open. When I will change the direction of the butterfly valve, here now you can see green cam is operated, so the limit switch contact will also change. So this is the way a butterfly valve operates and how the limits are operated with these cams. This cam is fixed with this shaft, and the shaft is connected with the pneumatic cylinder. We will check it again. Here you can see this is in the open contact and this is the close contact. Because green is operated and red is not operated. So when I will change the direction, you can see this is open now, because now